Very controversial, this. So, I'm in Carnaby Street. It's pissing down. Well, it's not now, it was. I haven't done a video for a few weeks, so I literally had to get out for you guys and create something. What I thought I'd do today, though, is shoot on the iPhone 11. As a little added bonus, I'll do a little Snapseed tutorial. I'm kind of changing the way that I'm processing my smartphone street photography. I kind of had the idea. I want it to have a more surreal kind of a feel to it, a bit like, almost like you know, how Paolo Reversi's fashion photography looks. Because I love that look. Guys, do us a favour. Please subscribe to the channel if you've not subscribed already. And hit the like button, guys, on this video. It's a big support for me. YouTube will share it with a bunch more people. And I know, it just motivates me to do more stuff. Thanks, guys. Right, so guys, remember to stay tuned. At the end of the video, I'm going to show you how I edit some of these pictures.
I've travelled down those trains up and down, and I've walked 1,000 miles on the ground. It seems so old, but still feels new. I've never met anyone like you. I hate to hear the clock as it ticks, when all I want to do is kiss your lips. I dream of you if only you knew. I've never met anyone like you.
I love the Hipstamatic app, and lately I've been using it without their inbuilt filters, because I want to process the image my way. I'm kind of not using theirs. So then why use Hipstamatic then if I'm not using their filters? Well, because I'm a big kid, basically, and I just love, A, the little camera visuals you can choose. It kind of makes you feel like you're shooting film still. And B, and lately I'm finding myself liking shooting square format. Like it constrains you, right, to shooting in a box format. It oddly feels more natural to me some at times, and at the same time it challenges you to shoot within a box. Any kind of constraint that you put on yourself, but also at the same time just trying out different things, doing things differently, is going to inform you creatively. You're going to feel good, and if you feel good, my experience is we take better photographs.
I've never met anyone like you.
Oh, that, I've read it. It's just amazing. You know Ramana Maharshi? Yeah, I've never been to India. I want to. I'd love to go. But maybe. I need money first. But thank you very much. People are beautiful, aren't they?
I've never met anyone like you.
In these street photography videos,
See, I'm shooting for you guys. Hopefully, it kind of reflects a little bit the streets that I'm shooting and my approach. But it can, I hope it doesn't come across that there's like this machine gun, scattergun approach to taking photographs. For me, if I get one photograph a day and sort of maybe five great photographs in a year, I'm happy with that with regards to my street photographs. This is like a process. So for me, patience, repetition, just like getting out on the streets consistently is more important than anything, really. There's a street photographer that I admire. His name's Richard Koci Hernandez. I'll put a link in the show notes. And I think it took him 5 years to get a particular shot that he was hunting down. I mean, he'd shot a whole bunch of other stuff. He wasn't just like waiting around for one shot, but this particular shot took him 5 years to get this shot. So this is not about just taking as many pictures as you can and hoping for the best, not in any way, shape or form. It's about feeling out the streets. Yeah, I found like sometimes on any shoot, the best stuff I'll get will come at the end of the shoot, like the last 15, 20 minutes after I've been shooting 3-4 hours at times.
Send it north to my mom if I die. Before I die. Before I die. Don't stand on my name, as we might not meet again before I die.
Some warm here. So we're going to get into editing for the smartphone on the smartphone, okay? And I'm going to be using Snapseed. It's pretty much my favorite smartphone app for editing photographs. I used to use Visco, which is pretty cool. It has a batch processing option on Visco, which Snapseed doesn't have. That's one of the cons of Snapseed. But at the same time, one of the reasons I like using Snapseed is kind of because of that as well. It facilitates you taking a little bit more time over the image. Also, there's a whole bunch more attributes that can be applied in Snapseed that Visco doesn't have, or never used to have when I used it. So I could be wrong. I love Snapseed, so that's going to be our thing today. Okay. So Snapseed, when you open it, should pretty much look like this. We're going to access our camera roll on the top left. You can scroll along to choose your image, or you can go open from device, and I think all photos, and that brings up a grid. It just gives you a more bird's eye view of your images. So let's just choose, this is something with a whole bunch of color. So this is pretty cool. This is in Carnaby Street. First of all, let me show you the interface. So on the bottom, you've got your looks. This is where we're gonna save the preset that we create with the attributes that we apply to an image. Then you've got tools, which we're gonna be getting into. And then on the bottom right, you can export the image after you've processed it. So tools. First of all, when you click into tools, it brings up a whole bunch of menus, and within them menus, there's a whole bunch more attributes. You access these by, okay, so tools, let's say top left, tune image, click there, and then we are actually in that menu now. To bring up the attributes, we need to thumb, and then it will show you we have contrast, saturation, ambience, highlights, etc., etc. All of the usual bum fluffery, right?
And then what we do, contrast, we use our thumb, drag right to apply the contrast, or decrease the contrast, drag left, and that's what, how we apply these attributes within the menus, okay? First of all, what I'm gonna do here, yeah, to go back to tools, I'm gonna apply, very controversial this, a glamour glow. Yep, to street photography, I know. It's something I've been doing recently, but bear with me, right? Glamour glow, and you've got, at the bottom here, you've got on this little timeline, you've got a whole bunch of different glamour glows that you can apply. We're gonna go for three, and then we're gonna hit the tick on the bottom right, and then we click on that, thumb that, we can see a before and after, and you can see what it's kind of doing. I think what it's doing is removing the clarity and the sharpening. What I wanna do is I wanna keep that glow, but I wanna bring some of that clarity back into the image, okay? So tools, top row, second to the second on the left detail, and I'm gonna zoom in using two thumbs, yeah? To, or thumb and a finger even, to apply some structure back into that, quite a lot of structure, and thumb sharpening to the right, okay? Tick, and then let's see what we've got, before and after. I just love that look. Then we're gonna go tools, and then we're gonna get into the curves, middle of the top row, and then we can click on this curve anywhere along that curve line and add a little anchor. So I'm gonna add three. I'm gonna add one halfway through the top of the curve and one halfway through the bottom. And then I'm gonna drag the highlights. So I do this by the top anchor, the node, drag it slightly. So it's just taking a little bit of the punch out of those highlights. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to the bottom and I'm gonna drag that middle bottom node down just to deepen those shadows a little bit, and then push the bottom node anchor up just to put a little bit of a fade on those shadows, give it a little bit more of a film look, okay? And then I'm gonna save that as a pre, I'm quite happy with that. What I've noticed though, I like, there's not a whole bunch of grain in this so far, and I do like a little bit of grain in my images. It just kind of replicates the look of film a little bit. It doesn't, but it kind of does, yeah? So, and Snapseed for some reason doesn't give you the option to add grain. There's not an individual menu for that, so, but there's a way around it. So what you can do is, you go to tools, and then can you see on the full throw down, grainy film? And then you've got a bunch of presets at the bottom, pretty much a little bit like Visco, I suppose. And then we're gonna go for L3, but it's too much for me. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna thumb on the screen, and it gives you two options there, grain and style strength. I'm gonna take the style strength complete, well, maybe we'll leave a bit of it in, 20% of that filter. And then I'm gonna zoom in so I can see where I'm at in terms of get a bead on how much grain I'm applying, and then push that grain. And then I think we're ready to go. If you wanna save that preset, you go to looks on the bottom, scroll to the far right, plus, and then you can save it. Let's call it color one, why not? And then we're gonna, let's fix ourselves up with a black and white as well, okay? Oh, hold up, first of all, let's apply this filter to another image, okay? So this open another image, and then let's choose this fella here, yeah? And then on the bottom, you can see we're in looks, color one. There we go, quite like that. A little bit over the top, perhaps. You used to fool around with it, right? We just kind of fine tune it and stuff like that. There's one I did earlier, look, let's go back to one of my earlier presets. Maybe it works better on it, yeah? Some of my earlier presets that I've created where I've taken a little bit more time. Okay, so let's lose that. So there's nothing on this preset now, on this image now, okay? And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna use this image to create a black and white. So we're gonna go to tools, full throw down, far right, black and white, and you've got a whole bunch of black and white options. I'm gonna go far left and choose neutral. So it just gives me a little bit more of maneuverability in terms of working with this for the purpose of this tutorial, okay? And then what we're gonna do, click on the tick, tools, and then we're going to go grainy film, but it's added a little tint of color to that, which we don't want, do we? So we're gonna thumb that, take the style strength totally, completely out of that, and then we're going to zoom in so we can see where we are, and then add some grain to the images, because I like grain. You don't have to apply grain, you understand. Okay, and then we're going to go tools, tune image, contrast, and I'm going to push that contrast way up, and then I'm going to drag the shadows down just to add a little bit more punch into the shadows, to darken the shadows basically. And then tools, curve, because you know what I'm like, I like to fade that those highlights. So let's add our anchors, three anchors, one in the top half, one in the bottom half, drag the top one down, adds a little bit of a fade, gives it that kind of fade, gives it a little bit of an old school feel. Yeah. Let's go to tools, tune image, and brighten the image. Actually, if we brighten this image, we need to, perhaps we don't want to be doing that whilst we're in the process of creating our black and white filter, because then it's going to add that brightness to each image, and every image is perhaps it doesn't need that. This exposure, this is a bit underexposed. Hopefully we're hitting our exposures, we don't need to do that. So what I will do, I will save this. So let's tick, go to our looks, far right, plus black and white. And then we've got a black and white preset and a color preset. To save the image, we'll export, and you can either save, which saves, modifies the image, or you can save a copy. So it doesn't touch the original image, it just saves a copy, which is kind of probably a good idea, especially when you're first getting used to the app, right? So open, and then you start, oh, we wanted to brighten this image, didn't we? So tools, tune image, brighten, there we go. And then we would save it again, yeah? So, and then you just start wading through the images. See what we've got. You can apply whatever preset you've created. It's the one we just created, the color preset. This is just scratching the surface, guys. It's tagged on to the end of this video. If you want me to do an in-depth Snapseed tutorial, then you need to let me know in the comments, and I promise I'll get to it. So, that's it. See you in the next video. Cheers, guys.
I've never met anyone like you.